The entire world is turned upside down and now is in Madara's grasp. Those tentacles didn't just reach the hidden leaf Konoha, they reached everywhere. The hidden stone, the hidden sand, the hidden mist, hidden cloud. Everybody right now is caught in Madara's jutsu. This is Solo Allen's giving his view of Naruto chapter 678, My Will. Things are right now on the edge, and the only one who is safe from it is Naruto, Ho, Sakura, Sasuke, Kakashi, and the old Hokages who are dead. Although you don't see the old Hokages in this part. Right now they're safe, and Sakura wants to know what's happening outside. Saying that, why would you want to know? Why would you want to know? Oh, you can't do anything. Okay, basically they want to know what's going on. But Sasuke being a dick, but he's not really being a dick. More as, can you help in any way? So basically, he's like right now countermanding. And Naruto's just bad mouthing and saying you shouldn't, because he's trying to defend her, even though he told her that. And then there's Kakashi, how she wants to know as well, and he can't do the same thing. But since he doesn't have his Sharingan anymore, only Sasuke with his Rinnegan is trying to detect what's happening outside. He explains that the jutsu has been activated, the infinite Tsukuyomi, anybody's in her dream right now, how they're all under Madara's spell, basically. And things right now are very on edge for them, because they have, because this is a very big risk right now. Everybody is in a dream world. Oh, you got Hinata's dream. You got everybody in a dream world. You get to even see some of the dreams. Hinata spending time with Naruto on a park bench with her sister Hinabi watching them, and Neji. Neji isn't dead. He isn't dead. Kiba dreamed to be Hokage. He's saying a special dog day or something. Like, he wants to make a holiday for dogs. And then there's Shino. No, with his new, discovering a new insect species, a giant bug that he can basically control. Then there's Shigemaru and Choji. Choji meets a girl that finally likes the way he eats, a skinny girl that likes how much of food he's eating, and basically he likes his habits. And then there's Shigemaru, he dreams that his dad, Haku, isn't dead. Things are back to normal. He's arguing with Mon, and that Asuma is alive and is spending time with Kurenai and her baby. And like, remember, Asuma's the father of Kurenai's baby. Maybe end of their marriage. Saying marriage is such a drag, and you get to see Tamari next to him. And does that mean that he has feelings for Tamari? But I'm off topic a little bit. Then there's Ino seeing Sasuke and Sai argue over her, and then her father, you know, saying my girl's all grown up, and remember, Inuichi also died right as well. And then there's everybody else's dreams. Gaara's dream, that he didn't have an unhappy childhood, that his life was in hell. Oh, that all his family and siblings really loved him, that his father was alive, so was his uncle, and that Naruto was his childhood friend. And it's also Tsunade's dream of him, that her lover Dan didn't die, that he became Hokage, and that Jiraiya was alive, but he's still teaching bad habits. There's the little kids, for example, her little brother Nalaki. Then there's also Tenten Lee's dream. Lee dreams that he defeated both Neji and Naruto, they struck, and the youth wins. Tenten dreams they didn't have, that they weren't so embarrassing, that they were level-headed, cool, and smooth, just normal people. But Neji is also alive. He's just getting a whole bunch of Neji moments, even though he's dead. I don't mean to laugh, but it's just, that's the way they feel. And also, that's character development. And then there's also the Mizukage, who dreamed that she had a husband. And for some reason, she has a problem with marriage. And to those of you who watched the episodes of Naruto Shippuden up to the early 200s, late 100s to the early 200s, episode when Sasuke declared war on the thing on the Five Kage Summit, all that, and then you get to see who else had the Raikage, Tsunade, Gaara, the Mizukage performing the marriage ceremony. It's pretty. Who the hell's the guy marrying her? I don't know. And everything else right now is on the edge. heads right now. The light dims away from the moon, basically. He and Sasuke dissolves the Susanoo. They're asking how do they stop it, and Sasuke says the jutsu uses the power of the Rinnegan, so they think Rinnegan can counter it. So basically, if they do have any chance of doing it, Sasuke is their only shot. So basically, since he has a Rinnegan, and Madara isn't gonna let them do anything. And even the Black Zetsu is not affected by it. He's basically a plant, and Madara, he's basically a plant. And Obito's mind is basically cannon fodder. So basically, and then there's everything out. Oh, it's like Madara, he tried to stop this, saying that this game over. I am the savior of this world, you know, and the game is over. But Naruto says all of it is just one big lie, because they're all in a dream. It's not reality. They're just being forced to see something that they want happen. It's their deepest desire come true. An ultimate genjutsu when everyone becomes one. And that's what Madara wants. Someone, all that under his control. He even tried that you two are in the way. And they all get to notice that Madara has become stronger, especially now that he has the third eye of the Jubi, the Rinnegan on his forehead, an eye on his forehead. Remember, that's... But then something happens. Obito stabs him in the back with his hand. Did Obito survive, or what's going on? But it's not really true. He's saying, hey, it's not... the game is not over, and it's not done yet. Basically saying, hey, you... Zetsu, what are you... He's saying, you, I'm not your will, you are all my will. Unlike Obito to use people, you are my creations. My creation, you are my will. I am not, basically he's saying, your will is mine, Kaguya. The Sage of Six Paths mother? That's insane. You gotta think about it. He just said Kaguya, and Naruto and Sasuke, to remember what the Sage of Six Paths said. As soon as Madara gained the power of the Rinnegan, he got closer to me. But as soon as he gained the power of the Jubi, he got closer to my mother. Remember, his mother was spiritually a goddess because of her insane power and strength. Remember, because she ate the forbidden fruit of the god tree, which created the Jubi. So basically, Kaguya... is still a lot. Basically, Kaguya's soul has somehow transmigrated over the centuries the same way. Think about it. Madara, Hashirama, Naruto, and Sasuke—they're the reincarnations of the Ashura and Kosuro, the Sage of Six Paths' two sons. And when their bloodline mixed, it allowed for them to be reborn in a way. But knowing this, how could something like that possibly happen? It's completely incredible. Now that the Sage of Six Paths have made an appearance, there's his mother. And the chapter ends with Madara's skin seems to be cracking, and like black roots are forming in the inside of his body from the wound. Is it Kaguya trying to take the power away from him? Was Madara a pawn all along? Or this is just a surprise out of nowhere that no one saw coming? Give me your comments and your review. I'll put the link down in the description. Tell me what you think. Because this was just a mind blown. Trust me. My mind is be blown out of anyone. Yeah. And now Madara is now the one in trouble. What do you think? Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. This is Sullivan Alaskew. You have now told chapter 678. Hey, my will. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Comment, subscribe. Give me your opinion. Signing off.